One of the things we did in the back half of the season was really ratchet up the tension in a couple of ways. We wanted the farm to feel less safe, and the way that we chose to dramatize that was we really needed a main character's death on the farm. Dale was really the only worthy sacrifice. We felt he was the voice of reason, the moral conscience of the group, and that was something that we really spent a lot of time thinking about. That wasn't an easy choice to make because it really sets the group adrift. But we felt that by not having a moral conscience, that put more pressure on Rick. And since I always see The Walking Dead right now as Rick's story, that was important. It's immediately after losing the moral conscience that Rick commits murder with Shane. Really, Rick kills him for one simple reason. He slept with his wife. That's it. You sleep with my wife, this is what you get. When they're all sitting there in the aftermath of the farm collapsing, Rick is the new horror. Rick has become all these things that he didn't want to be. He's been, in a sense, infected by Shane, by all of the terror that he's been dealing with. So Rick is the new threat. In season three, there's a couple of different settings. The show really resets in the premiere. There certainly is a prison that they still have to find. But there's other parts of that world that we want to open up. We're interested in following Michonne. We will introduce the governor. Tyrese is a character we're interested in introducing at some point. And so it's a much fuller world. It's a much more realized world. I think people have very clear expectations of how that story is going to lay out in season three. And I'll just tell you right now, you're wrong. It's already surprising. The very first scene of the premiere is a curveball. And we just continue to throw curveballs. We only throw curveballs, hopefully. So we really want to play against people's expectations. With the governor, we really looked at which actors were available and who was interested. And David Morrissey's name came up very early in the process. He's actually a friend of Andy Lincoln, so Andy called me and said, "You're crazy if you don't get this guy." Okay, we're lucky to have him. So David came in and read for us, and he and I had a conversation about the character, and I have a lot of thoughts about who the governor is and how he plays in the TV series, what we need to use from the comic book, and there's a lot to consider. David got all that. He really was excited. With Michonne, we opened up the process. We just asked talented actors to come in and read. We had several actors that we were interested in, and we flew Danai in from New York. And she came in and we met her, and she and I talked about the character, and she met the other producers. So the next day she came back, and you know, everyone's in the room, and you have the studio executives there, and she just was immediately their favorite. So she earned it, you know, she kind of blew us away and really had an approach. And knowing what we want to do with her, right now we're in the process of writing the first 8 scripts. So we know who that character is, what her backstory is, where she goes. We know particular scenes we need her to play, and we're more than confident that Danai will nail that and own it. What's important is that the show is always scary, that the show always plays as horror. That is my number one criteria for the show. How is it thrilling? How is it suspenseful? Why are people on the edge of the seat? Why do they not know what's gonna happen next, okay? That's really how I look at any pitch, any scene that we write, anything when it comes into the editing room. How can we make this scary? So whether they're on the run or they're holed up somewhere, it just needs to feel that they are trapped and there is no escape.